I have been holding out on you a little bit. Like, we've done all this talk about digital products and selling them in your own shop and selling them on Etsy and all the things. But I haven't really told you, like, one of the best ways to sell digital products. Like, if I were going to be like, this is the way to make $10,000 per month from a digital product, it would be the way I want to talk about today. And the reason I say that is because you do not have to have an audience already. You do not have to figure out Etsy SEO. You don't really have to do anything to make these successful except for know who you're talking to, what problem you're trying to solve, and you create good digital products to get them there. Those are like the main things. And you also might want to know just a smidgen about Facebook ads. So it's kind of one of those like you decide situations. Like if you want to sell digital products and you don't have an existing audience, you either need to build your audience and like send them to a store or whatever, or you need to use Etsy and really get good at Etsy and figuring that out. And sometimes in a saturated market, that's a little hard. Or you need to dabble around with Facebook ads and with what I'm gonna talk about today and figure it out that way. So digital products aren't hard, you just kinda have to pick which process you wanna go through. And this is honestly one of my favorites. When the very first time that I sold a digital product in this way, I was making somewhere close to $10,000 a month from my digital product with about $700 in Facebook ad spend. And actually, I think I'm mistaken. I think I was running ads on Pinterest, not Facebook. So you can run ads wherever you want to. But I'll stop teasing you. One of the best ways to sell digital products, if you do not have an audience, is with a sales funnel. Now, if you have not watched my video from last week where I'm walking through an SLO sales funnel and I talk about SLO sales funnels, you probably should go do that. But that's also kind of what we're going to talk about today. And most specifically, a small offer funnel or a low-cost offer funnel or an SLO funnel. These are funnels that are literally built on the backs of digital products. A lot of times people from the business side don't think about the fact that they are building out digital products when they build out an SLO offer. But as someone who's thinking about digital products, you need to think about an SLO offer for your digital products. I hope y'all can hear Rip ringing his bell to go out. He just went out. He doesn't need to go. So let me just explain how this works. An SLO funnel or a small offer funnel, whatever you want to call it, it has three parts. It has a main offer, like the main thing that people are going to buy. It has an order bump. And then it has a one-time offer. So what happens is on the sales page, there is a main offer. That's for your main digital product offer, okay? This is gonna be something like $7, $9, $17, $27, $37, like whatever, okay? Low cost, but main offer. And then you have an order bump, which is generally going to be less expensive than the initial thing. Now, the exception to that rule is if your initial thing is very inexpensive, like $7, your order bump might be just a little bit more. It might be 17, it might be, you know, something like that. But for the most part, your order bump is going to be a little bit less expensive than your main offer. And they have the option on checkout to be like, yes, I want this order bump. Then after the checkout, they get a one-time offer for something else that's a bit more expensive. And there are so many ways to configure this, like it's not even funny. So I have one funnel that the top of the funnel, like the step one of the funnel, is my ClickUp course, and the order bump are the digital products, the templates that go along with that. I have other products that the digital products are at the top, and then the order bump or the one-time offer are more like masterclass or course type things. I also have tons of SLO funnels or have run tons of SLO funnels before where all three levels of the funnel are digital products. So you can do this any way you want to, but that's the basic structure. One, you've got like the main offer. Two, you've got the order bump. And three, you've got the one-time offer. And it is a funnel in itself because there's gonna be way more people coming in at the top than there are who get the order bump than there are who get the one-time offer, okay? And then once you have this created, like once you have this all created, your main job at that point is to find an audience to funnel into the top of the funnel. Find an audience who might want to buy your thing and put it in front of them with paid ads, with organic content, with whatever you're comfortable with. If you have a large organic audience, then you might want to consider doing organic content. You might want to be like, okay, I'm really only going to promote this organically. I'm really only going to share this to my audience. It's a great way for me to make money, build my list, and for them to get the help they need. That's totally fine. But if you don't have an audience, you absolutely can and should run ads in some way to this funnel, to the top of this funnel. And that is going to be Facebook ads, YouTube ads, Pinterest ads, anything in that arena. Now, I am more familiar with Facebook ads. Like, I know how to use Facebook ads better than I know how to use any of the other types of ads. But I've seen people have success with all the types of ads. And like I say, my first one that was very successful, I was running Pinterest ads. But that's also because of what it was. It was essentially a digital planning like bundle. And so because of what it was, it lended itself well to Pinterest. But like business things lend themselves better to Facebook. So now you have the funnel, the main offer, the order bump, the one-time offer. You have a way to get people into the funnel, and then that's really it. Like, that's how this funnel works. You test it and you change it to make sure that it's working in the best way possible, but that's how your digital products sell without there being a major audience behind them. So let's say I wanted to sell a workbook, okay? And this workbook was going to help moms get organized. I don't know, just making stuff up, okay? And that is my digital product idea. I could put that on my own store, but what if I don't have an audience? Okay. I could put that on Etsy, but what if it's pretty saturated and I don't really know Etsy SEO? Okay. My next option would be to build one of these SLO funnels. And let's say that the top of the funnel is this workbook, $7. It gets moms more organized. And then I'm going to set up an order bump where they also get some printable labels to help them do some of the things that I'm talking about in the workbook. Okay, maybe that's another $10. And then I'm gonna set up a one-time offer where I'm gonna offer them like a video masterclass of how to organize a certain part of their home or a certain part of their life or whatever. So my digital products are making money on the front end, and then I've also now got this masterclass that's gonna make money on the back end. Your biggest hurdle at this point is to figure out the software you need and how to run Facebook ads or whatever ads you want to run. Those are your two biggest hurdles. And not to say those are small hurdles, to be honest, but again, you kind of just have to choose your hard. Is it building your own audience? Is it figuring out Etsy? Is it figuring this out? And like, that's kind of up to you. But in the next video, I'm actually going to talk to you about the tools you need to set up and run these funnels. So I'm going to talk to you about like what softwares you need, what things you need, what resources you need, all of that, okay? But I need you to know that if you're interested in selling digital products and you don't have an audience, this can be a really, really, really great way to hit your goals, build an email list at the same time, and build an audience at the same time. Like, you can use your digital products to build the audience. And what's really cool about this, and I should have said this in the beginning, I've said it in other videos and I think I just took for granted that y'all know this, but what's really cool about this is because of the type of funnel this is, hopefully, in the long run, hopefully at the end, this funnel is profitable. So ideally, whatever money you're spending on Facebook ads or Pinterest ads or whatever, you are getting back with sales from the funnel. Now, it may take you a little bit to get there to like refine the funnel to make sure you're running ads the right way or whatever, but ideally, running Facebook ads sounds scary because you're like, oh, I don't know that I have a budget for that, but it's not, because you're offsetting it with the sales you'll make from the funnel. Like I said earlier, I actually ran through me building one of these funnels a couple of videos ago. I will link to that below, and make sure you come back for the next video. I'm gonna talk about tools and softwares and processes that you need in place to build this type of funnel, but also all sales funnels, so that hopefully you can sell your digital products on autopilot super easily. If you have questions about this, please let me know in the comments below. I know y'all have questions and I want to answer them. So let me know in the comments below. I'm happy to do another video addressing any of those. And until next time, bye y'all.